Ladies and gentlemen, what the fuck is happening? Welcome to the General Banter Podcast. This podcast will be broadcasting on Tuesday the 5th. It's almost Tuesday the 5th. It's taken us so long to get going this morning. First of all, I'm here. I'm dressed in shitty clothes. I was supposed to be working out this morning. That didn't happen. I'm in the office hoovering. Okay. People are like, Colin, you've changed. They're like, correct, I have. I would never have hoovered before, but now that I have an office, I hoover it. And shout out to Road of Roadcaster fame for providing us with one of the best budget soundboards known to podcasting. And today we went to start and I went to plug it in and the fucking, you know, the old adapter just disappeared into it like a lubed up cock. Is that right? Correct. Does your mic work?
Does it?
Don't know. Is it just there for show? I have no idea. Can't hear. Which one are you on?
Two.
The black one?
Oh, it doesn't work. I haven't put on the bar.
Did we start again?
Nah,
fuck it. It's raw. It's coming at you live. This is what happens. We used to have a box here, like it was giant, and now we're working back off this fucking, taser over here. But here, it owes me nothing, this taser. You know, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of episodes recorded, lost, ran out of memory, ran out of battery, heap of shit. And here we are, just recording our regular podcast, like it's old school times. Did we mention it? Is it worth mentioning sponsors? What are they paying for? Us to record a shitty podcast. Anyway, we do have regular sponsors, manscaped.com, as usual, old school. They keep coming in there. They keep asking for things like, can you tell us, you know, they want the specific timestamp to when you do the ad. And they ask for it every month. And I tell my management company, I do it at the start. Listen to the start. It's at the start. Anyway, shout out to manscaped.com. They're the OGs. They've been hanging in there the long time. Manscaped is, I would say it's the best bollock shaver in the world. They're in the bollock shaving game and I couldn't name you another company that are. And they're in there selling the best product on the market. The Manscaped 4.0 they're on now. And that is used to just detangle those dick and balls for the winter. It's coming in the weather. In fact, it's this is the best time to advertise something like this because it's the perfect sort of gift for any male that you know. I'm trying to think of meals that you could buy. For, number one, buy for your father. Buying this for like your partner, like your wife or your girlfriend's dad would be hilarious, wouldn't it? That would be an awkward present. Go ahead, big lad. But yeah, listeners to this podcast get 20% off and it's across the whole range. You get the Manscaped for shaving the nuts. I think they have a thing called the plow now for shaving your face in a wet style. They've got the ball toner after you've hacked your bag to death and you put it on there and it heals up like Wolverine. Now I'm thinking about Wolverine's ball bag. What neck do you reckon that's in? Tight? Tot.
Same as his beard.
Oh yeah, just chiseled. Yeah, they got the ball toner, they got ball deodorant if you got those fucking stanky bags. And yeah, you can get 20% off all of that if you use the code GEMBAM1. And that's exclusive to the listeners of this motherfucking podcast. And there's my phone, I didn't even fucking turn it off, man. You know? So yeah, shout out to manscaped.com, use the code GEMBAM1, 20% off. Beer52 also in the mix. Sending out beer, there's a fly. What else could go wrong today? A fire alarm? Beer52, of course, the old school beer subscription service. Honestly, I've said it before, they were doing subscription services before it became the norm. Now you can get toilet roll on subscription. But Beer52 sends you out hand-picked sort of craft beers, 8 of them a month. You also get a magazine about craft beer, and you also get bar snacks, which are in there. And they pick out all these weird beers. IPAs, dippas, double IPAs, trippas, tippas, quadrippas. I mean, hops for fucking days, man. And if it's not hopped up, it's some sort of stout, which is, you know, more often than not like fucking treacle. But listen, it's good fun. you get the beer delivered to your house and you don't have to go anywhere. And it's just, you get the sample. They do all the hard work. They pick them out. And you just get to kick your feet up and fucking get hammered in your front room. What more do you want in this life? Listeners to this podcast, if you use the code BANTER, you get the first box for fucking nothing. For absolutely nothing. All you have to do is pay for delivery. And then your ad subscription ticks on for the next few months after that. Beer52.com uses the code BANTER. And because we have no soundboard today, Niall is now going to beatbox the intro. I probably have it on the computer, but fuck it. What other ads can we do while we're here? Our Patreon has got a bit more serious of late. You know, we've been coming in, we've been more regimented with our recordings, and there are some tiers going into place. That's just the way it has to be, just to keep everything fucking in line. I'm currently writing them up. And do you know what's cool about the tiers now? If you've already been on the Patreon, you still get access to everything that you could before. So it's just kind of like moving on from now, it falls into tiers. And there are four different tiers, starting at $1, going to 10. So even if you were sitting at $1, you still get access to a bonus podcast. And then the further up the scale you move to 3, to 5, to 10, you get more. And we will be looking into recording more stuff live in the or in the office, maybe some sort of live shit. Basically, I want to get drunk in the office and bring some people in. But once we get the internet in, we'll get on to that. And working on another little special of stand-up to put up there, which should be finished in the next while. So yeah, it's all happening over at patreon.com/GeneralBanterPodcast. Get on over there. I mean, it's promotions McGee today. The first 20 minutes of this are me just telling you about stuff I'm doing. I made a poster today for my gig at Theatre at the Mill in Mossley there. Mossley Mill, Newton Abbey. Which got moved out of a car park during the summer into the theatre. And people were giving me shit. They were like, you can fucking cancel a gig on us and then go to London. And I was like, absolutely, you fucking did. Do I want to do a gig in a car park, or do I want to do it in fucking Leicester Square Theatre? But listen, they're reopening the tickets and they're on sale now, so we're going to go to Theatre at the Mill. And I mean, it's the only gig ever that I'll be able to do where I could literally go to my granny's house for dinner and walk across the street and do it, which I might actually do. What else have we got to promote? This is welcome to Geddis Promotes. Geddis Promotions. You know, since all the things open back up there, people are doing their gigs. You know, I went to Mickey's gig there in the Ulster Hall. Shout out to Mickey for doing that. Paddy Raff had an arena gig. Everything's kicking off. Mine got moved, but they're still happening. They're happening in December, so get yourself some motherfucking tickets for that. I know people have lost out. Maybe they were like, listen, I was going to go to that specific gig and it's moved, now I can't go. Fair enough. There are probably a lot more people who are like, right, I didn't even know about the gig, now I can get a ticket, or now I can go, or I'm home for Christmas, or some sort of bullshit like that. So those tickets are still available for one of the shows anyway. I think it's the 21st. Anyway, quite literally, what else can I promote? We've got merch. I'm just going to go through it all. Gedzpromotions.org. We got new merch in. We're also going to do a big wave of merch for Christmas and the SSE gigs, but we got the Dead on Mafia military style t-shirts in there. Very cool, very swag. I love this. I'm going to see how long I can keep this going. FlowCBDLTD.com for all your CBD needs. They've been sponsoring this podcast for fucking ages. What do you need, man? A bath bomb? A gummy? Chill out. FlowCBDLTD.com for all your CBD needs. What else have we got? I've run out of stuff. That was exactly 10 minutes. Exactly 10 minutes of promotion. And, you know, people might go by this podcast, you know, like, oh, he plays the jazzy tune behind the promotions. But this week, they've no idea that there's 10 minutes of promotions going on there. And if you get over to patreon.com, 40 minutes straight of fucking promotions every time. Outrageous. No, I'm only messing. I'm excited to be in the office this morning. I was in the other day, tidied it up. Do you like it now? It's nice, isn't it? It's great. It's amazing how quickly you can fill a place full of shite. Just shite everywhere.
Literal.
Literal. Literal shite up the wall. Pete from downstairs came in the other day and I locked the door. And I got two headphones in. It was like tidying. And I locked the door just because, you know what I mean? Like sometimes you're sitting here and someone will just come in and be like, is this, the builder's merchants? Like, they don't know what the fuck it is. So I put the wee snip on the door, and he knocked the door. Obviously, I couldn't hear it because I was fucking just dancing around by myself. And then he rang me, and he's like, are you in the office? And I was like, yeah. And he goes, can I borrow some toilet roll? And I had to just give him some bog roll. And he's like, right, cheers. I'll take out my Tesla later. Because he was like, he goes, I'll take this bog roll, and then he goes, then I'll scare the shit out of you in this Tesla. And I was going home in about 10 minutes, and I was like, I don't want to do that. You know, I don't want the documentary to be like, and it, you know, 10 minutes before he was due to go home to his wife and family, he was taken out in a Tesla and went into a wall at 300 miles per hour. Apparently it's like stupid quick. I'm not gonna give the guy's name away, but his words were, it went so fast, your brain went spastic. He's like, it was so fast, you like forget to put your foot on the brake. Fucking hell. Elon Musk. Killing it in the car game. Did you see Elon Musk's GF there? Oh, did they break up? Just walking around, just dressed like fucking, what was she dressed like? That's like, is that a nerd reference or was she, huh?
Mad Max.
Yeah. You're like, oh, you've time to go out trolling the paparazzi. Look after your fucking drone child. For God's sake. I don't think at any point in the last 2 years when we've had a child would I be like, Maureen, can you watch the baby here? Do I go out and troll the paparazzi? Dressed as fucking Zelda or something. You know, she probably just got a machine which is like, listen, I have a couple of pranks to play on the paparazzi here, and just sets the baby in a white room and then just all this shit comes over. Tesla tits. That's the name of the podcast. Well, we developed a Tesla tit feed the child. What is this accent? Fucking loser. But yeah, you know there's just like a fake machine that breastfeeds the baby. Teaches it fucking Chinese. Crying in Chinese. So what I'm saying is the office is tidy. We're feeling good. Feeling great. What have we done this week? Maureen got good bloods. That was good. That was a big achievement this week. You know, she's been getting monitored to see where her bloods were. They told her, yeah, they're up fucking healthy. Full of neutrophils. And we went and celebrated immediately in General Merchants. Great times. I would say that's the benchmark for brunch in Belfast. What do you think? Have you been?
Yeah, I went the other recently in Australia.
Why didn't you tell me?
I forgot.
Did you get that street hawker thing with the eggs, no?
No, I got like the Mexican breakfast or something.
Oh? Burrito?
Oh no, it was the Asian breakfast. It was
like rice?
Salty or like sugary bacon bits and soy sauce and everything.
Oh my god.
Asian eggs, was it called Asian eggs?
I have no idea. It sounds a bit like that street hawker thing I got. Like the spicy eggs with like wee bits of bacon and fucking some sort of peanut fucking, what do you call that shit? Ryu or whatever. Anyway, it's good shit. Big event of the week. We went to Mickey's birthday. Went to Mickey's Ulster Hall show. And, you know, went in there. And now, this is hilarious. The last time I played Ulster Hall, first of all, we did it with the Comedy Squad back in 2000, whatever. The poster's around there somewhere. And I did that. And I was, felt quite under pressure doing, like, promo and stuff for it. So I was like, fuck this. If I ever do this again, I'm doing it by myself. And then I booked it by myself. And then that time when I arrived, it was quite literally posters behind the desk. And I talked about this before, but I walked up and I was like, hi, I'm Colin. I'm on tonight. And she was like, what's your name again? And I was like, I mean, if it was a sitcom, you'd be like, this isn't fucking for real. And I was like, if you just look behind you there, Sandra, four posters of me. So egotist. And anyway, got let in. We're like, can we get some water? And they're like, oh, the bar doesn't open yet. And you're like, what is happening here? There are 1,000 people going to be in here to see me. Can I get a fucking river rock up in this hoe? Different story this time, you know. Mickey was on. I walked up to the door and the guy goes, do you have proof of, you know, some sort? I mean, they were actually checking that. They were checking, like, do you have a vaccine card or a negative lateral flow test, which is like we're trying to sort of contain a pandemic here, and you're making me shove a fucking tampon up my nose and then rub it on a stick and then bring it in my pocket. Fucking rank. Might not be COVID, but someone's definitely getting fucking some sort of rank thing going on around here. Do you have a negative lateral flow? Yeah, hold on, just I pull it out of this fucking just snotty bag that I brought. There you go, bro. But anyway, I didn't have to get that out. I was about to get it out, and then some other dude with a beard, shout out to that guy, was like, nah, he can come on through. And I was like, cheers, lad. And then I went over to the desk, and the guy went, all right, Colin, and then give me, like, tickets in an envelope. And I was like, I could get into Mickey's gig easier than I could get into my own at the time. But shout out to Ulster Hall for having absolutely no security, because I just walked straight down the back, straight through the fucking fire doors and out to Mickey. And I was like, well, lad, what's the crack? And he came in for the hug. He's like, cheers, it means a lot to me for you to be here. And I went and swerved him and went straight to a bucket of icy Peronis. I was like, congrats and everything, Mick. What the fuck do you think I walked out the back for? To show you support? Get out of my road. Did I steal your free beers? Peronis day. Unbelievable. But yeah, it was great times, and it was good to be able to go to a gig and just watch the fucking thing instead of having some sort of hand in it. Sat in the balcony, watched Mickey. And a third shout out to the Ulster Hall for selling full-blown tepid pints of, not even, tins of Heineken. Put some fucking effort into it, lads. What other establishment can get away with that? You know, you just go into some bar and you're like, hey, can I get 2 Heinekens? And they're like, yeah, I've been keeping these just in my back pocket if you want an actual fucking, it's like a tin of bath water. If you want that. So I choked that down. And then I went to get more and they were like, no, we're closed. And I was like, this place hates fun and money. It's a fucking toilet. No harm to them. Nice people. I'll never be back. But I think maybe it's just like a lot of gigs I've done the last few years have been in essentially nightclubs. You know, the likes of the Limelight. And them motherfuckers and Laveries and stuff, they know how to take your money. They absolutely know how to take your money. If you were looking a drink, they would get you fucking drinks, no sweat. But not in the Ulster Hall. They're like, I don't think Graham, who works behind the bar, has the ability to hand you a can of warm Heineken past 9 p.m, I'm afraid. But we certainly made up for it because, you know, the in-laws were there. That's usually what happens when an event happens. I put a message in. I go, who wants to go see Mickey? And then usually I get like fucking 6 responses. So I ended up coming up the road with Maureen's 2 sisters. Luckily, one of them decided to drive. And I was like, absolutely. the big man's out to play. I had 9 of Mickey's Peronis in me before a fucking before a show started. And then afterwards, you know, we got you know, taken out the back and walked around to the Limelight, where the lovely people of the Limelight sorted us out a table at the back. And we just sat in there and got absolutely blasted. I mean, I said to Mickey the day I was like, I was drinking like I was going back to get fingered in a Holy Land house. You know, I'm sure a lot of girls are doing that. Like, oh, Jesus, I'm going to have to go and sleep on a bed here with no fucking, no mattress cover, no sheets on the bed. And you're just like, oh my God. You know, I like this guy, but I will be, you know, sleeping on top of a sleeping bag in a house with no toilet roll. What is it with student houses? And they're just like, no, we straight up just don't buy it. We straight up just don't buy toilet roll. I went to Aaron's house one time before we had a gig or something years ago. And I was like, right, I'm going up to your toilet here to have a shit, because that's how men bond. Okay. And I was like, I went upstairs. And now, 950,000 toilet roll, empty toilet roll holder things. Not a single sheet of toilet roll. Wipe my arse with a bag of Quavers. Sure, Aaron lived in a house one time where he lifted the top of the cistern because the toilet wouldn't flush and there was a dildo in it. Which, shout out to the previous owner, probably like, this'll be some crack. I'll leave the dildo in the cistern. There was it actually popped up on my Facebook memories the other day. Because he did a wee video. He was like, I was right last night. There's a dildo in there. And I think, if I remember this correctly, he was like, it was kind of brown. So, you know, maybe someone got caught. Maybe someone was in there dildoing their ass and someone tried to come in the room. I'll tell you what happened. Someone probably wiped their arse with it. In a fucking Holy Lands, they're probably like, I just had a shite. And then what's around me? A dildo. And they're just like, I'll just fucking try and smooth it off. I gotta say, like, I fucking, when I was at uni and I had to move into halls last minute because it was the only place to stay, all the guys I live with, it was like fucking, I mean, it was like Queer Eye. You know what I mean? None of them, one of them was gay, but like, it was like, everyone was cooking for each other. No, what are you making? I'm making chili this Thursday. Fantastic. Someone will walk in. I've got a fucking 24-pack of quilted things for your anus. Oh, brilliant. I'm doing washing while I do everyone's bed. Like, it was like, in fact, it wasn't really that gay. It was like, you know, like, I'm sure the way like firemen live, you know, where they're like, we don't really have to do much. So we'll get, we were killing it. None of these slobbish guys, like, you know, people were fucking, man, are we going out tonight? Yeah, fucking right. And then someone would be like, got this cheeky wee Malbec here. and a little discounted fillet of beef there from Sainsbury's. Fantastic if anyone's looking in. Heading out tonight, boys, on the Raz. I'm making a fucking seafood chowder. Guys, don't be late. Souffle's at 8. Before we head out to a wine tasting. It wasn't that bad, like, but, you know, it definitely wasn't these fucking animals that you see knocking about. I mean, hilariously, this is actually when I was in halls and I realised that I was allergic to crawfish because I bought a seafood medley out of Sainsbury's at 9 on a Friday night. It was definitely out of date. Definitely give me fucking the shits. But that's the sort of shit with that. Like, I didn't go to a fancy restaurant when I was like fucking 27 and realised I was allergic to it. I was making a fucking, you know, seafood linguine in fucking the halls of residence. And I have a terrible rash on my chest. I must be allergic. And then absolutely just fucking hurled everything up. It was like a fucking acid nightmare. Because after I've said this before, after the dinner, I then ate fucking Haribo's and Dr. Pepper. Like, when do you ever eat shit like that? And then I threw up and it was just like prawn, fucking gummy bear, ring. Blech. Pulling linguine, that's too much. So what I'm saying is, we went on the piss. It was a big weekend for Irish MMA round here. Did you see any fights at the weekend now? Liam McCourt was fighting. Our boy Reese McKee was fighting. And Paul Hughes was fighting. And he's the fucking... What did he win? Some belt there at Cage Warriors. And then Reese McKee... I mean, the Reese McKee fight was a fucking... Paul Hughes fight was a great fight. Liam McCourt's fight was great. Tough fight. Escaped a few Kimuras there. Meanwhile, we're watching this on a phone in the limelight. Everyone's having a great time behind us. I don't care. I love it. I don't care. And me and fucking... bro, what's his name? James? Is that his name? Mickey, sort of cameraman that shoots their podcast, huddled round a phone. Just two fat dudes talking about the ins and outs of jiu-jitsu. Yeah, I feel like if you put a knee there, you would definitely get out of that. drinking fucking Budweiser's out of a bucket. Yeah, the Reese McKee fight was actually the next night, but he beat the fuck out of some dude. Like, you know, I think that he went, built this way up to the UFC, goes in there, gets handed your man fucking, what's his name? I can't even say his fucking name. Kamzat. Tough fight for anyone. Probably on the come up, that guy, to be like, you know, a major contender. Loses that fight, whatever. And people are like, oh, fuck that guy. And then they put him back in something like Cage Warriors. And he, brutally assaults a guy. Didn't just beat him. Like, beat the sense out of him. One of those fights where, like, he's just so calm, picking him off, big dirty uppercut, and the guy's, like, flopping around the ring, just, like, trying to remember where he is. The ref had to step in and be like, that's plenty. Before you actually die in here. So, yeah, a lot of fun. Yeah, just a lot of fight, a lot of wins. A lot of wins for the fucking NI crew. Too old to be going out in the limelight, though. Although, I tell you what's weird, you know, everyone's looking to, you know, get out and about and live their best life and all that carry on. And a lot of students probably going to uni during a lockdown don't know any better. But see sitting at the back of a limelight and the DJ's pumping tunes like everyone's on the dance floor, except there is no dance floor and all these fucking kids are just like sitting at seats. And I'd seen it on the news, you'd hear people talking about it and all, but obviously I'm not going clubbing that much. And then I'm sitting at the back of the limelight just going, this is sad as shit. You know, everybody just fucking, and literally bouncers being like, sit down. All right. Fucking you. Strange. There must just be people sitting at seats, you know, like looking over going, man, see, check out these chicks at table 212. We'll keep an eye on them. And when they're leaving, we'll talk to them in the street. Unbelievable. It was just weird to see, like. At Dead Sea also, that's a terrible, what a terrible place to set that. I see, as we're going in the limelight, right, there's a fucking Honda Civic on the other side of the road with this woman dressed like a, did you see that on my stories?
Oh, yes.
This woman dressed like a stripper just dancing all over the car. And you're like, I know some people are a fan of Japanese souped up cars. But I wouldn't be dressed like a French maid rubbing my fanny all over it. Tell you what I love, a good old rice rocket of a car. Any wee Jap number there, just fucking with a dump valve on it. And I'll dump my valve all over the front of it. I don't know what was going on, whether they were dressed like that going out for... Did someone, as a joke, hire a stripper for their mate? You know? They're like, I cause of social distancing, we can't really do... the dance inside. So if you want to do it on the bonnet of a Honda Civic outside, mate. What is it with outside the limelight? Someone showed me a video the other day and they were like, oh, a girl got hit by a digger outside it. And I was like, what? She got out of a taxi and then a digger hit her and she fell into the bucket of it. What are the fucking chances? You know when people give you all the, oh, you're more likely to get eaten by a shark than you are fucking dying at a plane crash or something. They'd be like, you're more likely to get hit by a digger outside the limelight than you are fucking, you know, get hit in the head with a coconut and there. You know all those fucking stupid rules they make up? See if you can find that video. Will I look it up?
Yeah.
I'm going to look it up. Girl gets hit by digger. YouTube. Girl hit by digger. Lame late. Is this going to be one of these clips where, like, I talk about it and then, like, a week later someone's like, she died! And I'm going to have to fucking take it down. Hold like on, that girl like a finger on, in a taxi.
Keep me informed here. About some of the news.
Is that John C? You can't hear that, can you?
Girl got hit by a digger. I think it was a Saturday night.
Oh, the guy talking
about it. Saturday night.
And it said the Lamelight in Belfast. Ever. She just here, fucks her. She's in for such a claim. Such a claim.
You can't hear the audio, no? Guy goes, fuck, she's in for such a claim. Claiming her fucking kneecaps back.
In Belfast, ever, she has hair, fucks her.
That is rough.
Such a claim.
Look at that. Boom. If anyone knows any information about that girl... Let us know. Obviously you probably can't see out. If you're in one of those things and there's a lot of shit in front of you, you probably can't see right down. However, it did look like she was on her phone, which is like, how many injuries and stuff do you see with people just aren't paying attention? Like, so strange. Anyway, I hope she got away. I mean, it would just be so sore. Like, even if it didn't seriously injure you, it would definitely just smash your fucking legs to pieces as you fell into the bucket of it. Maybe one of those things where you're like, probably safer for it to hit you and scoop you along than for like a glider to hit you and just mash you to pieces. I don't care. I love it. But yeah, fucking hell, I was dying, so we were drinking Jaeger bombs. Mickey and the girlfriend were drinking Jaeger bombs too. Who do we think we are, like? And then we're leaving, he's like, we're going back to the hotel room. Fucking you! And she actually said jokingly, oh, Mickey's getting railed. Mickey's getting railed tonight. And I was like, go ahead, Mick, big night for you. And then he's like, yeah, I just basically sat up while she boked all night. TMI, guys. Probably not my place to be telling you that story, but listen, we're an open book here, as long as the book's not mine. And then the next day, I was just like, fucking, what? How can you have a night out and just not be dying the next day? What's the drug? Weed? There's not much hangover from a weed, but from a weed? Hey, 34. But you know, you're not having that much of a rager when you're stoned. Like, what's the drug? What's the drug gets you hype as fuck, and then the next day you're not just fucking trying to teach your 2-year-old child to like fetch your crisps. Eddie, go and get daddy crisps. Brings them in, not damn ones. Did you ever see that famous clip? What was that show where the guy would just go into your house? Do you remember this show? The guy would just go into your house and teach you how to like eat or something, but for like a week he would sort of monitor what you ate. Oh, yeah. What was that show called? You couldn't. I'm pretty sure the name was something like, oh, so you think you're a fat bastard or something? You couldn't even like. It's probably called like Fat Lives or something. Secret Fat Lives. What the fuck was it called? What was Secret Eaters? But there's a famous... The guy was like this real sassy gay dude. No, that's not the one. What is the show? Anyway. But there was a clip where, you know, he's sitting with this absolute fucking pile of laundry of a woman. And she's talking to her son, which is just like... Like, you literally feel like, you know, the fucking social services should step in and be like, you can't treat your kids like this. It's just like, sweetie, can you go get me... You know the discos? It was like discos or something. Remember that clip? Yeah. And he goes, she's like, not an individual bag, the 12-pack. if you come back with a single bag, I'm going to throw this fucking pint of water at your face. Multi-pack for mummy. The wee kid runs off and brings it back. I mean, honestly, I don't think that's far off. Like, do you know what people are? People get to the point where they're like, ah, can you just run down the shop and buy me figs, even though you're like 13, but the person in the shop knows they're for me? Short your fucking life out, you fucking fat bastard. Says me. Do you see that story, Kanye on a flight there? No. Why is that a big deal? Kanye West just got a commercial flight. Just like was flying somewhere and got a ticket and just got on a fucking plane. And everyone's free, like, there's people taking photos of him just in the back of a fucking, you know, Ryanair somewhere. I'd love to see Kanye just run at the desk trying to like get his bag in. I got 25 bags. We absolutely can't bring that on today. We can't bring that on. It's actually it's $89.95 for one bag. Add it up, I'm a millionaire. Well, the funny thing is, the price multiplies by 3 every time you add it back. Sir, can you please weigh your socks? Tell me how much your socks weigh, because there's a fee per sock. But yeah, everyone's freaking. But let me tell you something, like, man's got to go somewhere, you know? And he's like, can you be arse getting a fucking charter? What do you call it? When you just hire a fucking private, a chartered flight, is that what it is? I think so, yeah. You just fucking hire a plane for the day. He's like, that's a whole pile of rigmarole. He's like, I'm near the airport. Ryanair, have you got a ticket? And they're like, who is this? Kanye West, is it? Then he's like, yeah, just get me on the fucking plane. I need to go. And then everyone's freaking out because he's on the plane. Put my dick in your mouth. Let's get to the real. I was supposed to review this a couple of weeks ago, and I forgot. So it's a little Chet Hanks documentary. Me man, Chet Hanks, boy! Because obviously half the world are going... I mean, have you seen that latest Google ad where they're trying to be all woke?
No.
The first thing someone types in the search bar is, who can say wagwan? And I was like, this is the most transparent way that a fucking, you know, like, globally massive company can appear woke. Who can say wagwan, you white bastard? Who can say wagwan? You know, just some fucking Michael Scott type character going into a meeting at Google in the morning. Wagwan, my days! I'm gonna see if I can get it. Hold on a second. Girl hit by digger at the limelight. We've had some search history this morning. Google ad, you know, and it's basically there it is there. They got a guy going up to his black mates and he's like, wagwan, and then they go, what do you mean wagwan, fam? And then eventually they're like fucking slapping hands and all, like, it's alright, we're not gonna fucking do you in this time. You white fucking son of a bitch. And I definitely don't play this, we're not gonna be able to you can't hear it, can you?
No.
Oh, fucking bullshit my tits. Just the Google meeting in the morning. Hey guys, good morning. By guys, I mean just fucking generic theys. How do we appeal to the mandems? Look, there's a white wagwan, wagwan.
It's okay.
Wagwan.
I don't know.
I mean, is it appropriation? I mean, it's always like, I mean, obviously, you know, the white man has done all right for himself there, hasn't he? If you're a fucking young lad like that, living in an area where all your mates are fucking black or something, and they're like, wagwan, and can you not say that? You know? Is there not fucking dudes from Ghana moving into Dublin? And fucking a month later, like, what's the fucking story? You know what I mean? Who can say that? We're getting cancelled. Look, there's a bunch of fucking dudes just doing a wee prayer on the roadside there. I mean, is that what happened during for COVID? Is that what happened during COVID? They're like, we can't let you in the building, but you can pray outside, bro. I mean, surely you're at a mosque.
I've seen. I know. Yeah. Because they have to pray at a specific time.
Aye.
I remember we drove past on the way to Galway. There was a couple lights on the side of the road. Like on the motorway.
Was there?
Yeah.
Was that on the way home? Because I was drunk on the way home. Really? The boys just pulled the car over and had the prey?
Yeah.
Oh, what if you were late and you were like, I'm fucking going to get petrol on of the prey? Wagwan with that. Remember the old mosque was jammers and had to do it outside.
To be curious. To be clueless.
There's a black... Oh, there. That's the opposite. That was the guy Googling what do you call it? Achille or something? You know, there's the black guy looking awkward, like, what the fuck are these white people doing?
To wonder what that is. To wonder what to do. It's okay to ask. After all, it's not our questions that define us. It's what we do with the answers.
Who can say Wagwan? It's not... the question, it's what we do with the answers. So what happened there that he didn't get kneecapped by these four black dudes? Who can say Wagwan? Is this look at the look on his face, like, what the fuck? I mean, what is Google trying to do here? Like, sign over any life experience, you know, let us explain to you how culture works. We are the wokeness. We are the wokeness. Come together. Don't you be bothering living your life and experiencing things and finding things out yourself. Come to Google and I'll tell you Wagwan, okay? How scary is that? We're two weeks away from your phone being like, you seem sad. And I'll be like, fucking tell me about it. Tell me about it, Siri. We got Wagwan. What is it, Kaylee? There's a black guy in the middle of that, as if, like.
Because the more we learn, the closer we get.
Could you parody that and just be like, who can say N-words? And the guy just goes up and goes, Wagwan, my N-words? And they just beat the shit out of him. And that, you know, you just the thing just buffers, waiting for the answer, and then you get your shit kicked in, and it's like, only black people. You're like, fuck! I risked it. Anyway, back to my boy Chet Hanks, boy! Has Tom disowned him yet? Should.
I was hooking up
with... Did he? Long time!
Chick, one day, she was on the phone with her family in Jamaica, and she was really in the middle of a heated conversation.
Tell that pussy clad girl, you know what?
I really had no idea.
It's, I mean, honestly, if it's like a character, it's the best thing I've ever seen. You can't hear this, can you? He's basically like, this is another fun element, me explaining to you what's going on. He's like, I was hooking up with this chick once, and she was on the phone to her family in Jamaica, and he's like, you fucking pussy clad.
The fuck she was saying. And her friend said, "Fimi pick Nina to Kiara with me so I can chat." I'm like, wow. So, wait,
what
break
the
that
fuck
down.
Did, what?
Can chat. I'm like, "Fimi pick Nina to Kiara with me so I can chat." And her friend said, "Fimi pick Nina to Kiara with me so I can chat." I'm like, wow. So, wait, break that down. So then she started breaking down a lot of shit. I'm like, how do you say this? John no star. How do you say that? Up like seven. Oh. She was just telling me how to say different shit. So I got for like a week, like I was really on a Jamaican tip. And that just happened to be the week of the Golden Globes.
Big up the whole island massive. It's your boy Chetana coming straight from that Golden Globes, you watching? Big up, tune in.
I turned my phone on and the video had gone totally viral.
Yeah, that's Chet, you guys. I am shook and frankly, hella confused.
Big up the youth, them way out the Kingston.
It's just, like, why? I just don't get
it. that guy just goes, you know, it's like, why? Just why would he do that? Well, do you know what?
Appropriation.
I had Jamaicans blowing up my Instagram. Respect, General.
So, yeah. I've totally changed my mind now. He said he was... going out with a Jamaican girl, and then he just was picking up all the stuff. But you know what? That's those Tom Hanks genetics in there. The guy can mimic. He's sucked it up off this Jamaican girl, and now he can just go like fluent fucking, what's the word? Patois.
Come to the island, you know.
But he was saying like he's basically getting approval from all the Jamaicans and stuff anyway. Fair fucking play to you, big man. Chet Hanks.
The Jamaican people showed me the most love, hands down. But then you got all these social justice warriors in America saying that I'm a fucking villain.
How do you feel about the idea of cultural appropriation overall?
I don't fucking know, dude. If I'm interested in fucking bullfighting, I can fly to Spain and go watch a bullfight. And if I want to go talk to a matador and say, hey, bro, can you teach me how to fucking fight the bulls? And he's like, hell yeah, bro. Here, put this on. He's stoked that I'm stoked, right? Some asshole out there.
Okay. Cultural appropriation. This is weird that you can't hear this. He basically goes, you know, can I take an interest in Jamaican stuff and learn about the Jamaican thing? He goes, I can go to Spain and go to a bullfighter. Like, oh, I love this shit. Can you teach me about bullfighting? And he's gonna show me. So how's that cultural appropriation?
Was that Jack White?
Huh?
Was that Jack White?
Who?
That bullfighter.
Imagine. Yeah, that's actually from that fucking music video. Conquester? Is that what the song's called? It's cack like for a White Stripes song.
Here, put this on. He's stoked.
That's mad that that's the clip.
I'm stoked, right? Some asshole out there is gonna
I love like, imagine you tried to apply that to anything else. You know, is it cultural appropriation if I go to a bullfighter and learn about bullfighting? You know, in court, like, did you murder these people? I can't watch a movie and show an interest in murdering and go to a murderer. What's the best way to dissolve a body? What the fuck going on with that?
I'm fucked up because I'm culturally appropriating the matador culture. But I'm not even like...
You didn't even have to go that far, you know, like appropriating them, you know, the culture. I mean, like Adele wore that fucking Jamaican bra and had her braids in because she was going to like that carnival and everyone's like, Adele, you skinny fat bitch, what are you doing?
Though, because all these haters, they're on the way out, dude. There's more people that fuck with what the fuck I'm saying than there's people that are angry about what the fuck y'all are talking about. And that's a motherfucking fact.
Big up the whole island then, man.
Just don't do that. Don't even do that.
Why not?
You just need to practice.
I think, you know, he does all these things and he obviously had a Jamaican girlfriend and he can do this. He can do the accent fucking down to a T. I think it's more... People just see it and be like, you fucking wanker. I don't think people are going, man, I can't believe he's stolen black culture. I think people just see it and go, what a fucking ball bag. It sort of is that, isn't it? Like, just fucking, what a fucking D-bag. Like, cool guy. Like it. We'll hit some questions, will we? I thought I was going to get more funniness out of that, and now I'm fully turned over to being a Chet Hanks fan. Now I love him even more. Me can't, me not cultural appropriating when I appreciate the culture. I've seen bad versions of that where, like, you know, there was someone, you know, in America went, you know, literally worked as a chef in fucking Mexico for, like, whatever amount of time and then came back and opened a taco place, and they're like, you can't have two fucking white guys owning a taco place. That's at a point where you're like, yeah, they're not doing it to like steal culture. They're doing it because they really like it. And they're cooks. You fucking knobs. Listen to this horseshit, Cian McGivern. What's the best cafe in Belfast and why is it Bob and Burt's? If I had that button, I'd be like, would you fuck up? And where is Bob and Burt's in Belfast? Do you know?
No.
Probably like Victoria Square somewhere. I mean, it's not bad for, I mean, there's one in Oma, and if it was down with Iron McCann, we would go there because it's, you know, the best of a bad bunch.
Yeah.
And they're good with the cakes are good. I'll give them that. They had the gay pride cake with a full fucking rainbow through it. Vomited immediately. But just because of the too sweet, not because I'm, you know, made, brought to the point of physical sickness by the idea of homosexuality. In fact, I'm stiff as a cobra. But there was one day we went in there, me and Aaron, actually, this is when me and Aaron were like going for runs, like two hippos run down the street. And I went down and we went there, and then we went to Bob and Bert's, and I was like, right, let's get a fucking panini here. And he was like, I'm trying to stay healthy. And then he got a Caesar salad, which had to have been 4,000 calories. You know, I was like, just because there's lettuce in that doesn't mean that there's also, you know, chicken, bacon, parmesan, garlic, mayo, and dressing, and then more cheese shaved over the top of it. Mine's not great, you know, it's some sort of chicken panini, but at least it's not, I'm not just like putting spoonfuls of mayonnaise in my mouth. And he's like, I know, there's fucking lettuce in it. Bob and Bert's, best cafe in Belfast. I mean, I don't think it's Bob and Bert's. I mean, what makes a great cafe? Coffee?
Eggs.
And yeah, the food. I mentioned it earlier, and I don't know why they haven't reached out and, you know, said, you know, do you want to put like a dish on this menu? I don't know why they haven't reached out. I don't know why they haven't named a corner of it the Geddes Corner. I don't know why they haven't done that just yet. But General Merchants is by far the best, like, without a doubt. If you could take O'Donuts coffee and put it in General Merchants, I'll never leave. Get me an office in the corner, the back corner, that little alcove. The General Banter, General Cafe collab. I would love that. That's my dream. If I could get a meal in there, or a pizza in somewhere, what would be your custom, you know, like, pizza? If you had the fucking, the Niles Oars 16-incher. We'll be on it.
Don't know. Not too much. Something simple.
Coffee granules and... Mine would probably be like... You see, I either like a plain pizza or I like... Sometimes I like everything on it.
Yeah.
Like like really big, juicy fat boy.
I do when it's like Domino's or something. But if it's like stone baked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if it's Domino's, you're trying to kill, like, you're trying to kill the shit pizza with, like, toppings.
Yeah.
I gotta say, there's a, we were in LA, I got one of those pizzas, I forget the name of it, Alfredo or something, I don't know what the fuck of it, it's like white, there's no tomato sauce on it, it's like a white sauce and then cheese, with like chicken on the top, and it was fucking unreal. And then I had another pizza not that long ago that was something similar with like mozzarella and chicken and like pesto on it. And I don't really even like fucking pesto, but that was amazing. But I think if I had to make a custom pizza, I would get some proper like shredded, slow cooked, like sugary ham on the top.
Yeah.
On the top of the pizza. And then I would have to have a wee think about what else. Because it might be a spin on like a, like a Hawaiian. It might not be pineapple, but like something salty, some sort of salty meat, something sweet on it. If it was making a custom bad boy. Hard to know. But General Merchants, yeah, all I'm looking for is a booth decorated to my liking, seats that I like, and a dish of my own on the menu, and no one else sits in it the rest of the week. That's all I'm like. Talk about it every fucking week, man. Where else is good? I was in Grand Central the other week. In that meeting, remember? Had the best decaf I've ever had in my life.
Decaf.
At that point in the day, I'd already had about 7 coffees, and it was in the meeting, and they were talking, and the sides of my vision were closing in. I'd had so much caffeine, but sure. Right, we've talked for an hour. Have you watched Squid Game? No. If so, do you think something like that could go down here? And what would it be? I don't know. Have you seen? What?
It's a game. It's like a game show about people getting murdered. How could that go down here?
Well, that would be great.
It's actually class. I watched the first three episodes.
Yeah, I'm going to get into it.
It's really cool.
Yeah, I'm going to get into it.
No dubs. Fuck dubs. It's all in Korean.
Oh, is it?
But it's not, there's not like loads of dialogue, so it's okay.
How can North Korea be like, you know, they're eating grass and like fucking rats are eating people who are still alive, and then South Korea is like hugely technologically advanced?
Yeah.
I got an LG TV there, they're Korean. But I had to buy a new TV because literally the sun had bleached the other one stupid. And it's fucking, you know, it's got like a laser on it. You know, you just fucking move the remote to where you wanted to go and click it. From the other side of the room, just like, no, people have probably had those TVs for months and are like, Colin, maybe you should have got a new TV sooner. Howdy, Cormac Meenan. Have you ever heard of the joke amongst experienced comedians called the aristocrats? It's something I think you and I bunch would be awesome at, since the joke, which can involve a great deal of improvisation, is so profane. Why am I going to be sick? Usually only comedians have heard it, and it became legendary as a way for comedians to perform and top each other backstage. Have you seen that? It's a fun documentary called The Aristocrats. And it's basically, the joke is, there's like a traveling sort of family that are like trying to sell themselves to like some theater or circus or something. And they're like, what sort of act do you do? And it's a family, and the bit in the middle is someone describing to this person what the family does, and it's who can be the most disgusting, you know? So it's like, right, starts off, you know, the dad does a fucking handstand, spreads his cheeks, and the mum, you know, pisses into his, and it just gets worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. And there are certain people who are like really, like the Doug Stanhope does it. I'll not play the whole thing. Doug Stanhope does it, and he's doing it to a baby. So he's telling this joke to like a fucking 2-year-old who doesn't know what he's saying, thank Christ. And you know, he's obviously a fucking pig of a man. A wrist. Fuck me, come on. Where is it? How do you spell aristocrat? Aristocrat? Yeah, so he tells us,
one more joke and then we're going to bed because your daddy has shit to do before last call. A guy walks into a talent agent and he says, I got an act for you. And he says, okay, tell me what it is. My wife's dressed up like Charlie Chaplin and she looks completely like a dude. And she walks up to me, I'm sitting on a park bench, and I start to perform horrible analingus on her. And then she exposes her breasts. The crowd goes crazy. We drop her pants completely down. They see my wife has a penis because she used to be a...
You can't hear any of that, but he's basically saying a lot of things like analingus and... And it sounds even better coming out of Doug Stanhope because he talks like fucking... He sounds like fags. And
it's kind of a horrible...
That goes on for 4 minutes, you know, and it gets more and more gross, and there's pus involved and cum, and they're squelching around and felching, and... It's not really a good joke. It gets to the end, and then he goes, amazing, what do you call yourselves? And he goes, the aristocrats. Right? So it's like... It's so like Norm Macdonald, like the whole joke wasn't even worth it, but it's the journey. So yeah, that's basically it.
Hormone shrunken penis, but a penis nonetheless. So
it would be funny. I mean, it would be me shooting it for just, this one guy who's requested it. But that's it, that's the whole point of the joke. And the whole point of the joke is it's like not even that funny at the end. If you were given money to design and make a sex toy, what would you come up with and what name would you give it? Naomi Mitchell. It has to exist already, does it not? I'm sure like whatever I could dream up would already exist. You know, if you were like, oh, if you get something like a fucking fleshlight that just moved on your dick, and then someone will just send me a link to Amazon, I'm like, the old cock shifter. And it's just like, nink, 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 nink. You know? Just pulling the fucking dick of yourself. I mean, you would just get the, you would just... I've joked around before, you know, like if you were like, if you could take a shit, get sucked off, and also have someone put those like cotton buds in your ear, you would just die of joy. So that would be mine. Mine would be like, like one of those fucking head massagers with a wire on it that goes over your head. And then two of them are just like two wee furry things go in your ear. But then also like one of those angler fish or whatever. It's just got a long pipe that comes the whole way around and also sucks your dick for you. And you're just going like, oh, while it tickles the inside of your ears and also fillets your pipe. That would be my sex toy. A name? I have no idea. Oral sex, you know, with but spelt like your ears. Nice, nice, nice. The sound guy got. I mean, I did do a bit before the podcast about those Japanese cocksuck machines, but just so funny. Like, is that happening again? I think the right, you know, people are like, there's a bit of money in sperm donation now. People are probably more and more like, yeah, I wouldn't mind a kid, but I don't have to deal with all this guy's horse shit. You know, so the value of, never mind fucking Ethereum. Urethrarium. Urethra. Urethra coins back.
All in.
It's all in. I feel like the sperm donation thing would be, there would be such anxiety around it for me. I feel like you'd really have to shake your dick up for a good 2 hours so you got that healthy load. You know what I mean? You don't want to be going in there with the old fucking, the pearl tears. You want to be fucking, you want to come out and be like, here, most of that just spilled over the edge. The rest of it's on the floor there. You know, you don't want to be squeezing it out like an old tube of toothpaste. Like. You know, you'd have to get real comfortable in that fucking room. Look, Garrett, what's your go-to album at the moment? Flew home from Manchester for your SSE show and was gutted when it was cancelled. Still is excited for the new date. So, yeah, I apologise deeply for that. That's the people who got fucked the most, is the flight goers. Did you come home, you know, see anyone? See the folks? I don't know. What's your go-to album at the moment?
Mine's the Smashing Pumpkins. For some reason.
Oh, Halloween themed?
Yeah.
I need something to listen to. What did I listen to? I went on a bit of a... I was definitely on a Black Keys binge the other day. Went back over some Black Keys. Go-to album. Let me just check my phone, see what I've been listening. Do you know what the go-to album was? This is so embarrassing. I had listened to like the new Drake album, trying to get into it, and I was like, man, this is fucking not hitting the spot for me at all. And then I went back and listened to old Drake. So about the last 3 or 4 times in the car, I've been listening to Nothing Was the Same by Drake. 34-year-old dad boner. Okay. There's a link here. Ever changed the car and find some interesting names in the Bluetooth history? Second from the top was a nice treat. Oh, this is a real thing, is it? What's this actual photo link here? Google Photos. Someone's old Bluetooth connection. Lick my nut. Zappo iPhone? Who was that? Zappo, good lad. Frank Zappo. Fucking Frankie Zappo. Best sub 20 minute weights workout. Listen, you're talking to the right guy. Because if I ever work out, I don't want to be doing it for longer than 20 minutes. You just pick fucking, you just pick some things that are punishing and do fucking 12 reps of each and repeat till the 20 minutes is up. The one that fucks me the most, and I've done this, I had you know, the little push-up handles that you put on the floor? I'd do that. I would do like 12 push-ups and then I would whip the two fucking 22.5K dumbbells and do overhead presses, you know? And then I would just go straight into like a sort of Romanian deadlift with those. And then I would do like a goblet squat with like a 24K kettlebell and just keep doing it. And it fucks you right up. Or throw maybe some swings in there. Just do like 12 of each and just keep going for 20 minutes. But that'll burn your tits out real quick. But like, you know, it's one of them things. It's like, if I've only 20 minutes, what do you do? And you're like, I don't know, fucking sprint up a hill. If you want to knock your dick in for 20 minutes. They turned Alex Jones' rants into a folk song. Here we go! That's only funny if you've heard the original. You still can't hear it. I'm not getting used to it. Alex Jones, bro. What's your opinion on esports? It's a continual gain. It's continual gain in popularity as well as wealth. Mad to think if my man Dad had just let me stay inside and play more fucking video games, I could have potentially been a millionaire, probably. E-games. Now, number one, I don't play any computer games at all. Number two, I certainly am not going to watch people play games. But I do understand that, like, you know, people used to be like, oh, what sort of fucking fat incel is being a computer game champion? And then you see them and they train like fucking, you know, like Formula One drivers. You've got the gym here and then I eat this salad so that my thumb just works really fast. You know, you obviously have to be in good shape and, you know, at the Asian level, you know what I mean? When you're competing against some Japanese fella, some Korean who's fucking hasn't slept since he was a baby. Were you ever into collecting anything as a child? Just the usual shite, like, you know, football fucking cards and fucking pogs, whatever they were in. But not real. Nah, nothing really. I honestly just played a lot of sports when I was younger. From a young age, just was mad playing football. Just bought a light for the missus that casts the northern lights, the moon, and a few stars on the ceiling. Thought it would be shite, but honestly, it's pure class. As someone else, I've heard talk about shitty impulse buys. Any other gems you can recommend? I did buy the little planet with the two magnets pushing against each other, and it floats. Have you seen that? Did I ever show you that? It had a wee base and then the thing floats on top. Apart from the baby, pushed it over and smashed it. Fuck yes. Impulse, but I mean, every fucking day of the week I buy something stupid. I am Mr. Impulse. Everything is, like, I'll buy fucking, the latest one was, I had a punch bag in the garage and if it was stuck, I would, you know, just needed to do a quick workout, I would just be out and be like, and then I seen someone had like an aqua bag. You ever seen one of those? It basically comes like a fucking big balloon, and then you hang it up where the punch bag used to be, and you have to get the hose and put it in the top and fill it up with water, so that when you hit it, it's got a big, nice feet like ding, it pings back at you like you're hitting the body, ding, 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 bloop. But I absolutely drowned the fucking garage setting it up. Because I did that thing where I shoved the hose into it and didn't allow for any, like, air to bleed out. So it was just filling up and then it just went up. and shot out the top, and I'm like fucking you know, I didn't know where to go first, the top or the, it was a fucking disaster. Do you have a personal favourite Ian Fighter video? Not really. I literally couldn't even fucking tell you what happens in any of them. If someone was like, do you remember an Ian Fighter 7? I'd be like, nope. They're all shit. It's all people had at the time. If you look back now, it's absolutely wank. Amory Dougherty, is there anything you'd like to collect or already have a collection of besides your watches and runners? I'm up to 39 bottles of whiskey on my display now. Damn. Not drinking enough. No. Better than you. Hello. Collect it in my arse. Collect it in your fucking liver. what else do I collect? There are a stupid amount of watches there. I have an abnormal amount of guitars for a guy who can barely play the guitar. You know, there's fucking about 6 or 7 guitars there. Which is quite sad. When was the last time you were genuinely terrified? There was a moth in the car the other day and nearly fucking flipped it over a hedge. When was the last time you were genuinely terrified now?
Spiders.
There was a period of time in my life that I call spiders. probably being in hospital with Maureen, they were like, we need to keep you in. I shit myself there. That was a level of fear where you're like, it was nearly like hallucinogenic. You know, like a level of like adrenaline where you go like, you know when people are like, oh my God, I had to pinch myself? Like that sort of like, you're like, what? Like disbelief, you're that scared? I can't stop laughing at this kid. Let's see what it is and then we'll absolutely rip through these questions. Wonder who should we have on the podcast this? We should book some more guests in, I think. Oh wait. Little lad tells his daddy will uppercut Santa if he keeps him on the naughty list. Yeah, I might have seen this. Is he Scottish by any chance?
Swear.
You aren't absolutely. That's why you're on the naughty list.
I will swear, trust me.
Well, that's why you're on the naughty list, because you're being naughty right now. So you're going to be on the naughty list if you keep talking like that.
No, because Father Christmas is not being very nice to me.
Because you're being naughty, so you're on the naughty list.
No, I'm not. I'm on the good list, actually.
You're not, because you ain't being good.
I am on a good list. If you keep saying that word again and again and again, I'm not on naughty list.
Father Christmas rang me last night when I was at work,
yes,
and said, you better tell Jackson to start being a good boy or he's going to stay on the naughty list and he won't get no presents for Christmas. That's what he said to me. So you've got to start being a good boy.
And then I'll do an uppercut to him.
No, you won't do it. No, what?
I'm going like this. Punch him. Punch his beard off.
You're just silly, man.
They trust me. I'm not on bad list.
Okay, he's going to uppercut Santa. Now, you know, before I had a child, I'd be like, that's funny. And now that I have a child, I'm like, he learned that from somewhere.
Yeah.
You know, there's a kid running around going like, I can uppercut someone if they fucking disagree with me. Love the green light and green tops you happen to be wearing in the last pod with William and Patty. Different than the Chappelle setup. Cool that you mix it up. We went for an orange light and a green light. And by chance, Patty swung past Sports Direct and had himself a fucking green top on. But yeah, we can mix it up every day. What colours have we got today? White?
White and red.
White stripes. Have you ever heard of Dirty Blues, Pure Filth from the 20s? Right, this podcast is getting out of hand. There's too many fucking references here, man. Too many video refs. Dirty Blues. Lucille Bogan. That's a fucking mixed up name. Now, if bet you laugh at it, then you trace it back and you're like, oh yeah, they stole some, you know, already colonized people from Africa who spoke French and had French names and then took them to America as a slave and then some fella from here called Bogan owned them. And now she's called Lucille Bogan.
I got a man I love. I got a man I like. Every time I fuck them ends, I give them the doggone claps. Oh, baby.
Excuse me, sir?
Give them the doggone claps. Every time I fuck them ends, I give them the doggone claps. Oh, baby. Give them the doggone claps.
Oh, like Dirty Blues, like she's saying dirty words in it. That's weird to listen to. The 20s, it's got all that clink, 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 blues piano. And then she's like, when I fuck that man, that man. Saying dirty words in it. Good job they didn't find her. They'll fucking chop their hands off or something back in the day. I don't know what the fuck.
But that's the kind of pussy that they really like.
I wish you could hear this. This is filth. Like, it literally sounds like one of those ancient recordings. She's like, that's the kind of pussy. Fuck me. I'll listen to that by myself in the toilet. You think WAP was bad? My 1920s pussy, give you the clap. Actual lyrics, like actual, not far off the lyrics. Have you listened to Greta Van Fleet, Real Zeppelin Vibes? No. Do you listen to them? Okay, Niall doesn't like them. Fan of Pearl Jam, question mark. Also, when is Aaron making an appearance again? I miss him. Well, he lives in London, so next time he's over, I'm sure. Fan of Pearl Jam? Yeah, sort of.
We got the classics.
Yeah, the bits I know I like, you know. Flew in, got cancelled, September SSE, just booked to come back for your rescheduled gig. Is it definitely going ahead or is it still pending restrict? No, the last shows, the restriction regulations were pending and then they're not, you know, they got lifted and then shows were able to go ahead. But mine were so close to the decision that they had to fucking move them. And then a week later or something, you're going to see, you know, Mickey and whatever. Went to see the amazing Mickey B, Friday night, superb show. That guy has funny bones. I did notice that throughout his show, he would occasionally glance at his watch, wondering how you time your set to make sure you get everything in. Or if something is working, do you elaborate for more laughs? I don't know. Yeah, like you could tag some stuff on the bits and whatever to draw it out a bit, but you're not buying yourself that much time. You're just, it'll only take a few more seconds usually, but he was probably just checking that he was doing enough. That would be the, like, you're coming out of lockdown, you're trying to write new sets, you're gigging all over the place. He was probably going, like, you know, if he looked at his watch and he's like, I know where I am in the set, and, you know, he looks down and he's like, right, I've done 45 minutes. I know I'm able to get another 15 out here. Something like that. Taint barbecue sauce. Are you on a big hot... Are you big on hot sauce or draw the line at sriracha? Taint barbecue sauce. From Andrew Brogan. I do like hot sauce, yeah, but I'm not one of these mad bastards that collects it. I sort of know what's good. Sriracha's a good one because I do like the Asian-y flavours, but I'm not buying some fucking, what's this called, tingling taint. I mean, that's funny, all these habanero hot sauces, I'm not that into it. Like, I'll eat it if it's there, you know, like hot sauce out of fucking Nando's and all that shit. I'm not a big fan of that flavour. So have you seen any of the fella Donkey 262 mostly on TikTok? I think I have. Is he the guy from like the fucking North Coast somewhere? I read someone's left a video in fucking red. I think it's that guy. I mean, he's like, if fucking Barry the Blender was like a real person all these years later. Taint, tingly taint hot sauce. Nice. Aye, there he is. There's our fella there. Let me see.
Alright, you son of a hers, what's the crack of the dead boys? The moment is here that you've all been waiting for. I fucking hope, anyway. The merch is officially on sale now, boys. The online shop is up and running. Hey, I'm telling you, I'm glad to fucking hear it. Or I'll tell you for a way. I fucking caught Big Jimmy there, even there, sitting down a big burnout in the fucking Leon, hey, and he's burnt the two front tubes clean off, the old bastard, says. No, fuck they here. Get on there.
Well, there you go. The man's got merch now, which is cool. Fantastic. Yeah, I've seen some of his videos. This is our final question, and it's just a link to something for sale. Let me see. Ready for this now? The cast iron Hitler nutcracker. So you put a... I mean, how often do you really need a nutcracker? I mean, you can even buy a bag of fucking shelled pistachios. But I would buy that, no bother. Was I talking about that? Do you watch that show, How to Be a Dictator or something? What was it called? A Tyrant or something? Did you ever see that show? Like, apparently the Hitler mustache was, like, made famous by him. But apparently, like, what it was at the time was, like, European men would have a mustache like that. And it was usually, like, a sort of working class thing. And they were saying that at the time, you know, he was always wearing, like, military stuff and dressed down and had the mustache of, like, the people. So that's kind of why he looked like that. He was trying to be like, listen, I'm a fucking man of the people here. You know, I'm not out here wearing fancy suits. I'm dressed like you guys. I've got your fucking working class mustache. You know? Now let's gas some fucking Jews around here. Now that we're all on the same page.
There's 6 of them in stock.
I mean, who needs 6? You could bust 6 nuts at one time. What nut needs cracked? A walnut? Is that it? Have I told a story on here about Maureen's uncle giving me the walnut? This is fucking... I've definitely told this before, right? Maureen's uncle moved to Portugal. Right? And the place got ravaged by wildfire. Ravaged! Razed to the ground. And, everything was fucking destroyed. And he went back to the site and fucking lifted, like, a few belongings that survived the fire. And he, like, scooped all these, like, walnuts from his, like, a walnut tree on his little bit of land. And he brought them home. And he was handing them out to people. He was like, oh, there's the walnut and walnut and, you know, at home there, there's big fires or whatever. And as he said it, I had it in my hand and I just went, like that. And went to eat it. And he goes, and these were just, like, the only thing that survived the fire, basically. I just thought it would give me... And it was so hot. Like, I could have done with a Hitler nutcracker. I crushed it so hard in my hand that a bit of it went in my hand and it was bleeding. And he didn't even get to the end of the story. He was like, and I just wanted to be like, you know, these are the only things that survived, you know, life goes on. At least I have my health. And I'm just like, before he got to the end of the sentence. Oh, and they were slagging me about that recently, and I was like, listen, at least you have a funny memory now, because I bet, yeah, none of you bastards can even find your fucking walnuts. I had a fucking sore hand for about a week. It was like just a bit of shard of wood going in there. Anyway, let's get the fuck out of here. Cheers for listening, folks. Cheers to our sponsors, manscaped.com. Get on there. Use the code GEMBATON1 for 20% off your dick shaving equipment. Beer52.com as well. Use the code BANTER. Get a free box of beer. And that's it, folks. We're recording a Patreon podcast tomorrow. It'll be out Thursday, 8 a.m. We've been 3 weeks in a row now. We've been out at 8 a.m.
3?
2?
Longer? 4?
We've been doing the Monday, Tuesdays?
Yeah.
Have we? I can't remember. I think so, but we've been pumping out bonus episodes every motherfucking week, you know, because I was hit and miss with them for a long time there, but we're back, we're up and running, working on some more stuff to put on there, so get over on the Patreon, my guys. Cheers for listening. We'll see you on Thursday.